constitution. We are going to discuss about making of Indian constitution, seven features, preamble, citizenship, fundamental rights, the active principles of state policy, fundamental duties, center-state relation, emergency provision, constitutional amendment. Before we talk about Indian constitution, we must know the real meaning of constitution. What is the purpose of constitution? Why do we need a constitution? It is a fundamental law and fundamental principle of the nation on which the government is based. It is the framework of the distribution of powers between various organs of the government and within central government and state government. The concept of constitution was first originated in the United States of America. A country is usually made up of different segments of people who have different beliefs. So constitution is helpful to fulfilling the belief of different segments of the society. Is it clear? So this is the purpose of constitution. Okay, now we move on to the main topic, Indian constitution. Indian constitution is framed by the Constituent Assembly, set up under Cabinet Mission Plan 1946. It held its first meeting on December 9, 1946. Dr. Sachidanand Sinha, an oldest member, was elected as the temporary president of the assembly. While the work was in progress, unfortunately he died. Then Dr. Rajendra Prasad was elected as the president of the assembly. Similarly, H.C. Mukherjee and V.T. Krishnamachari were elected as the vice president of the assembly. It has met 11 sessions along with 166 days of the assembly. During the session, 2473 amendments were presented and some of them were accepted by the assembly. It worked through various committees and the draft of the constitution was prepared by the drafting committee under the chairmanship of Dr. B.R. Ambedkar. Then he recognized as the father of Indian constitution. Finally, the constitution of India was adopted on 26th November 1949. Then it came into force on January 26, 1950. That day, we are celebrating as the Republic Day of India. So this is all about the making of Indian constitution. Next, for your kind information, Prem Bihari Narayan Raizada was the calligrapher of Indian constitution. The original context of constitution was handwritten by him in the flowing italic style. Now we move on to the salient features of Indian constitution. It is the lengthiest written constitution of the world. It has borrowed most of its provisions from various countries' constitution. Say for example, our fundamental rights have been adapted from the United States of America. Likewise, directive principles of state policy have been adapted from the constitution of Ireland. So, we call it as borrowed constitution. Next, it is partly rigid and partly flexible. In this sense, we can amend the constitution whenever and wherever is necessary. It establishes federal form of government. Federal form in the sense, the country has two forms of government, this is central government and state government. It establishes parliamentary system not only at center but also in the states. It makes India a secular state. Secular in the sense there is no particular state religion in India. All religions will be treated equally in India. Right. Next, independent judiciary. Independent judiciary in the sense there is the separation of power between executive and judiciary. Next, universal adult franchise. The citizen, those who have attained 18 years of age, are eligible to right to vote and elect their representative. That is, we call it as universal adult franchise. Then, single citizenship. Single and uniform citizenship for the citizen of the whole nation. Next, it provides special provision for the minority, scheduled caste, scheduled tribes, and other backward classes. So, this is all about salient features of Indian constitution. Now we move on to preamble. The term preamble refers to the preface or introductory part of the Indian constitution. It deals with the ideals, objectives and basic principles of the constitution. Thus we call it as key to the constitution or ideals of the constitution. It is based on the objective resolution drafted by our first Prime Minister of India, Jawaharlal Nehru. So the text of preamble begins with, we, the people of India, having solemnly resolved to constitute India into a sovereign, socialist, secular, democratic republic and to execute all its citizens. Justice, social, economic, political. Liberty of thought, expression, belief, faith and worship. equality of status and of opportunity, and to promote among them all. Fraternity assuring the dignity of individual and uniting and integrity of the nation. In Constituent Assembly, this 26th November 1949, do hereby adopt, enact and give to ourselves this constitution. So this is the entire text of the preamble. Now we move on to the ideals, important ideals of constitution. Number one, sovereign. Sovereign in the sense there should not be any external interference of any kind in the functioning of the government. Then socialist. Socialist in the sense all will be treated equally in India. All are equal before law. There should not be disparity between rich and poor on the basis of social status. For the better development of our nation, there should be social justice and economic justice. In a sense, if we talk about economic justice, the equitable distribution of wealth and income among the citizens should be equal. Right? So that is equal justice. Next is secular. As I told you already, secularism, this is, there is no particular state religion in India. All will be treated equally in India. Next, democracy. Here people's power is ultimate. The citizen, those who have completed or attained 18 years of age, will be eligible to right to vote. So people power is ultimate. I would remember Abraham Lincoln, 16th president of USA, described that democracy is government of the people, by the people and for the people. Republic. The term republic refers to the head of the state shall not be hereditary but will be elected by the people. Next, fraternity. It indicates the spirit of common brotherhood. In our pledge, we used to say that all Indians are our brothers and sisters. So, it is very important to maintain the unity of nation. Fraternity is a spirit of common brotherhood. So, this is all about the preamble of Indian Constitution.